Hi, everybody. It's Coach Williams, and it is week four. And if you're following along with our schedule, we should have finished our individual research last week, and we are now moving on to a different portion of the research, which we call the reveal videos. So last week, we individually brainstormed, and then we went through some research. Now, you can use any websites for research, but I provided some for you on our website about the three subsystems of a robot, about the chassis, the lift object manipulators. Something that you probably found on this website right here, the three subsystems of a robot. If you're not familiar with gearing and how you can increase speed or torque by using different size gears, that's something you probably should learn about as well. But all of this leads you to develop an understanding that will help you when you get to the reveal videos. Now, the reveal videos are a type of video that people that design robots for VEX games will post on YouTube. And often these are pretty advanced teams that design robots very early in the season. And they put their first design or second design or third design on YouTube, not only to kind of show off what they've been able to accomplish, but more importantly, to share their ideas with us so we can help figure out what types of mechanisms will work good for this game of the season. Now, there's a couple ways that you can find these videos. Of course, you're going to use a Google search method, and there's different terms that you can use that might have different search results show up. So some terms you might use would be VEX or VEX IQ and reveal and video or the name of the game of the season with the word VEX, maybe the year. These types of different combinations for your search terms will help you get the different videos that people post for the season, and more added as the season go on. So once you're done with your individual research, if you haven't already gotten into teams, this is the time to do so. So as a team, you will divide and conquer the work, because this can be pretty time consuming to, first of all, find all the videos and then go through them and see which ones you like. And then once you have figured out, okay, our team likes these three reveal videos. Now make sure you collect the links that you're looking at and put those in your notebook so that you know which videos to go back to. You have a resource of links to go back to. And you can say, okay, well, we like these three videos. Let's have this partner pair or this pair of students are going to look at video one. And this pair of students is going to look at video two. And this pair of students will look at video three. And the reason we do this is for two reasons. One, it's kind of hard to figure out what you're looking at. So it helps to talk it through with somebody. So it helps you make sense of what you're looking at when you can kind of question and throw some ideas off of a partner. So you're looking to see if you can identify the lift, the chassis, the object manipulators, the types of gearing. Did they use chain? Did they use track? What type of parts? You're trying to figure this out as you look at their video and take notes. You'll draw sketches, you'll label, and you're really trying to figure out what did these people do to build a mechanism that was able to play the game. So probably you want to make sure you're not doing the same video with someone else on your team. So again, divide and conquer the workload. And once you're done with this, you're going to take all of your research and your ideas from the reveal videos, and you're going to develop an idea for a robot. So we're going to go to the next page called Developing Ideas, and you're going to take all of your different brainstorm and research and all the ideas from your reveal videos, and each person's going to develop a different idea for a robot that they think is best to design to play the game this year. So a few questions you might ask yourself is, what do you want the robot to be able to do? You need to make sure it has mechanisms to pick up the game field element or lift it and place it on a pole or shoot it into a goal. So do you have a mechanism to do what you want to do? How tall does the robot need to be? What kind of lift will you need? Will it need to stretch? Is there a game field element it will need to stretch to? Make sure your lift would be able to do that. But is there also a constraint on expansion? Another constraint would be the starting size. So can you fold up these mechanisms so that they can fit within the starting size? And how will they unfold at the start of a match? Did you see any robot designs that inspired you in the reveal videos? Did you see a robot, an entire robot system that inspired you? And it's okay to try and copy somebody's robot idea that they have in a reveal video, but you're not going to be able to see every part. So you really need to like work it through and push pause and play and see if you can figure out those mechanisms. But you can develop an idea solely based on what you saw in a reveal video, or you can mix and match the ideas you have from your brainstorm, your research, and your reveal videos. The one thing I do suggest you do is go over your ideas as a team so you're not all designing the same exact robot. So there's a variety of design ideas that you're going to put into the decision matrix, which is the step we're going to do next week when you choose the best idea. So talk to your team. Everybody develop a different robot design that they're going to contribute to the variety of ideas that we will choose from next week. Now, there is a video talking about how to develop ideas. There's a little bit more information below, like the golden question in VEX is why. Make sure you can answer the question why when you are designing a robot. Why did you choose that chassis? Why did you choose that object manipulator? There should be a reason. Does it go well with another subsystem? Is it, you need to be able to answer that question to try and explain your idea to your teammates and help them understand what you're thinking. It's important that every person on the team designs at least one robot idea. And when you do this, you're going to need to draw and sketch it out on a piece of notebook paper. And you could do this on white paper if you need to, but graph paper usually helps you with your lines. But you'll need to draw a chassis and a lift and an object manipulator, and then also show how these are going to integrate together. How will they connect? Will there be bracing? And these are pretty simple drawings. Obviously, not all of us are really great at drawing, but that's okay. Your notes can help you communicate your ideas, and it might be helpful to also include a pros and cons list to help communicate why this would be a good robot and what might be some of the problems or issues that you would deal with if this robot was chosen. So your goal this week for week four is to, one, divide and conquer the workload of looking at the reveal videos. Dissect those videos, push play and pause, make sketches, take notes, and then everybody individually is going to design their own robot design idea that they think will be the best robot to play the game this season, and make sure you include all the subsystems and how they're going to integrate together. And if you have time, feel free to develop more than one idea. Okay, everybody, good luck. There's a lot to do this week, so don't waste time. And I look forward to seeing your design ideas or what you come up with on the game field. All right, good luck.